female patient in a rural telehealth clinic lobby is struggling to complete her intake form while the clerk is scheduling over the phone. She returns the clipboard to his desk. A nurse enters.
Best I can do is put you on Wednesday's schedule, but make a note that if you, if we get a cancel sooner, if something opens up.
Hi, Ms. Perez, you want to follow me back and we'll go see the provider?
Yes, ma'am.
The patient and nurse enter an examination room.
Ms. Perez, today you're going to meet with your provider via our telehealth link. She'll ask you some questions about your pregnancy, and then I'm going to examine you using our telehealth machine. And your provider will be able to see and hear all the same things that I do. But before we do that, I'm going to get you to put this gown on, okay? Just make sure that it opens in the front. Gracias.
The clerk knocks on the exam room door. The nurse steps into the hall to speak with him.
Excuse me.
I was entering Mrs. Perez's information, found she left a lot of her intake form blank.
Text on screen highlights the CUS tool, which the clerk is about to demonstrate. CUS is an abbreviation for three statements. I am concerned. I am uncomfortable. This is a safety issue.
I'm concerned she doesn't speak English, and I'm uncomfortable going forward until we can be certain she understands what we're saying to her. Since this is a patient safety issue, let's get a medical interpreter to join the telehealth call. I know it'll delay things and the schedule's tight. How do you feel about moving on to the next patient while I call healthcare interpretation services?
You know, I think you're right. Just a few moments ago, she did respond to me in Spanish. Let's see if we have an interpreter available. And once we have an interpreter, I'll help Ms. Perez finish answering the questions. Will you let the provider know that we'll be delayed getting on the telehealth call?
Sure, I'll go call him right now.
Thank you so much.
Video rewind effect. Text on screen. The CUS tool was used to stop the line. Now watch how SBAR, situation, background, assessment, recommendation, was also used to communicate clearly. Situation.
I was entering Mrs. Perez's information, found she left a lot of her intake form blank.
Background.
I'm concerned she doesn't speak English.
Assessment.
And I'm uncomfortable going forward until we can be certain she understands what we're saying to her.
Recommendation.
Since this is a patient safety issue, let's get a medical interpreter to join the telehealth call. I know it'll delay things and the schedule's tight. How do you feel about moving on to the next patient while I call healthcare interpretation services?
You know, I think you're right. Just a few moments ago, she did respond to me in Spanish. Let's see if we have an interpreter available. And once we have an interpreter, I'll help Ms. Perez finish answering the questions. Will you let the provider know that we'll be delayed getting on the telehealth call?
Sure, I'll go call him right now.
Thank you so much.
Organizational logo, AHRQ, Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality, Department of Health and Human Services, USA.